Morphogenetic fields. Unlike electromagnetic energy, interacting with biology through principles made clear in the well-researched field of organic chemistry, subtle energy and its many puzzling features make empirical categorizations a more complex study. Timeless descriptions of a universal life force informing the mind and body permeate the healing doctrines of all human civilizations, except for contemporary medicine, a philosophy blinded by its successes and the appeal of scientific materialism. Countless healing modalities that have been scoffed at by modern healthcare now have a scientifically valid foundation in physics to explain the presence of subtle energy moving within the body and how the mind creates health. What is a morphogenetic field? Morphogenetic fields are invisible forces that guide developing embryos into the magnificent, complex organisms that comprise the plant, animal, and mushroom kingdoms. The concept of a morphogenetic field was made popular by cell biologist Rupert Sheldrake in his 1981 book, A New Science of Life. But it was actually first introduced in 1910 by Alexander Gerwich while studying embryonic development. Understanding how and why organisms take shape the way they do is fundamental to understanding life, the universe, and everything. This process of morphogenesis is still a huge mystery in developmental biology. Coming from the Greek words morphine, meaning form, and genesis, meaning coming into being, morphogenesis is the biological process of how a developing organism takes shape. Morphogenetic fields are hypothesized as the invisible pattern-forming agents which guide the biological process of development from embryonic globs of potential into fully structured complex organisms. It has become common to believe DNA and the genetic information stored in chromosomes are entirely responsible for the way an organism looks and operates, right? Well, not entirely. Genes are only responsible to code for protein synthesis. They are the building materials from which life develops. But morphogenetic fields are like the intelligence of the architect. They analyze the blueprints and explain what building materials go where. For example, our arms have the exact same DNA in them as our legs, so we need a proper explanation for why they look so different and how the body knows to form them in such distinct fashions. Humans, like all mammals, employ Hox genes, abnormally well-structured genetic instructions that determine a body's anterior-posterior shape and where body parts grow during embryonic development. The morphogenetic field of intelligence is what informs the body about how and when to use these genes. This invisible field is also the key to how amphibians like newts can regenerate limbs. This invisible, pattern-forming agent, the morphogenetic field, instructs the cell to access specific genes in the DNA and mindfully generate and connect protein sequences to become the unique, functional, organic structures we see and exist as. They can be thought of as fields, just like the invisible fields produced by magnets, which can be seen clearly when you sprinkle iron fillings around them. Science has yet to find an iron filling which clearly elucidates the flux lines of morphogenetic fields, but we can understand them as the functional organizing force of all organic life. Even though we understand the developmental mechanics of gross matter without acknowledging the presence of consciousness within the body, we have no way of understanding why and how our bodies have such innate formative intelligence. Since the dawn of scientific materialism, natural selection by random mutation has been the prevailing dogma, that organisms look and behave the way they do because of chance genetic variances that either made them more or less fit to survive their environment. Today, we know this picture is not complete. Natural selection is a theoretical understanding that models the survival of the fittest, but fails in addressing the arrival of the fittest. Natural selection cannot explain the emergence of the genomic and cellular features central to the building of complex organisms. Not only does natural selection fail to fit within a reasonable evolutionary timescale, it also does not address the genesis of the genes themselves, the original design and development of DNA. After he applied statistical analysis to study the origin of life, pioneering astronomer Fred Hoyle concluded that the probability of abiogenesis, or life arising randomly from inorganic materials sloshing around in a primordial soup, was comparable to the chance that a tornado sweeping through a junkyard might assemble a Boeing 747. Evolutionary biologists must acknowledge the immaterial presence of intelligence as the primary developmental factor of all life. These invisible forces not only shape complex multicellular organisms like you and me, they also shape unicellular organisms like radiolarians. These single-celled organisms all share identical DNA, but are observed to form in different, complex shapes. Another example can be seen in flatworms. You cut up a flatworm into pieces, and every single one goes on to form a whole new flatworm. Regardless of what part of the flatworm you cut, it still creates a new head and a new body. What's even more bizarre and remarkable is that all of these new flatworms can even remember things learned by the flatworm they were generated from. Perhaps the most fascinating example can be found in the single-celled organism Acetabularia, a genus of green algae. Referred to as the mermaid's wineglass, Acetabularia is a single-celled organism that can grow up to 10 centimeters in length, which is huge for a single cell. But what's even more incredible is they can regenerate an entirely new Acetabularia from a cutting of the stalk, recreating the entire form without any of the genetic information contained in the nucleus. A triumphant hint that genes do not control the process of morphogenesis. The chakras, the vital applications running the circuitry of our physical bodies, are like the magnets that produce and move these fields of morphogenetic energy throughout your being and organize the development and maintenance of your physical health and well-being.